Natalie.
Hello.
How excited are you about Taylor Swift's new album, Folklore?
So excited, as you can see from my little buns here.
I know. I'm so excited. So Taylor Swift surprised us all with a brand new album that she wrote in like 3 months during quarantine. 16 whole songs.
Yes.
My top three, because you asked, are The One, Cardigan, and Invisible String. Bonus fourth, The Last Great American Dynasty.
Wow, you really know those off the top of your head. I think, full discretion, I'm not as big of a fangirl, but I gotta love her.
You gotta love her. Okay, which was the name of her last album?
Oh.
Love her.
Yeah, I know that.
Okay. All right, so I thought we would do some statistics on her 16 songs on this album, because I was looking at the length of them, and I thought, oh, I wonder if this is kind of like a bell-shaped curve.
Uh-huh.
And it's close.
Okay.
And so I thought maybe we could do some practice with Empirical Rule with this album. So we see all of the 16 songs right here. And what should be, like, let's use some technology, not do everything by hand. What do you think? What should we do first?
Okay, so first let's just put the length of each song in the L1 list. And then we'll go to one var stat to go ahead and find the mean. And it looks like the mean is going to come out to about 3.98 minutes.
Okay.
And then while we're at it, let's do standard deviation, which should come out to about 0.53 minutes.
Okay, so like half a minute-ish.
Mm-hmm.
So that's the typical deviation from that center.
Yep.
Okay. And if we scroll and look down a little bit, we could even notice that the median is kind of close to the mean. What's the median?
3.93.
Okay, so kind of close to 3.98.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And I actually did a little background. Now, looking at the histogram, it's not super bell-shaped, but I did a little analysis that we are going to study more in later chapters, where we can look at box plots, which is next section, and what's called a normal quantile plot, and some other little details. And I went ahead and said, you know what? In my analysis, this data is approximately bell-shaped.
Okay, and another word for that is normal.
Yes, all normal curves are bell-shaped.
Mm-hmm.
We'd be a little careful because not all bell-shaped curves are normal. We'll talk about the t-distribution later. But we kind of casually use those words synonymously. So normal, bell-shaped.
Right. Yeah.
Okay, so the empirical rule applies to bell-shaped curves. So I thought, why don't you and I do a quick recap of the empirical rule, and then I bet just knowing that will help us whip through a bunch of these questions.
Yeah, once we know it, we can do those questions really quickly. And if you never bleed, you're never gonna grow,
and it's all right now. I'm gonna draw a bell-shaped curve, and we have our mean down the center. We've got our standard deviation. So this will work for any bell-shaped curve.
Mm-hmm.
The empirical rule is an approximation technique to what percentage or what proportion of data values are within a certain number of standard deviations from the mean. So we can go one standard deviation this way, one standard deviation this way. What percentage or proportion of data do we have there?
68%. Which means that each of those are 34%.
Right, I love doing that, like where we wanna actually focus on what does that mean, the percentages in each little region? Because
mm-hmm.
that will make our life so much easier and these will be faster.
Yep.
This is also something that we refer to a lot throughout the course, like all the way to the very end of the mm-hmm. course.
Yep.
So in here, I'll just note we have a little 34% and a little 34%. And we mean of the data values.
Yes.
Or geometrically of the area.
Yep, the area under that curve.
Right. Okay, let's go out another standard deviation in both directions. Then what percentage of data do we have within two standard deviations of the mean?
That is 95%.
Okay, so note, 95% in the blue, minus the 68% in the yellow, which mm-hmm. now kind of looks greenish, mm-hmm. Is 27%. So we have 27% left over to share between these two regions I'm shading here.
Right, which means that each region there is 13.5%.
Yeah, 27% divided by 2 would be 13.5%. Let's go one more standard deviation in both directions. What percentage of the data would we have within 3 standard deviations of the mean?
So that's going to be 99.7. And we can kind of do the same logic as before to figure out what each little region would be there.
99.7%. Mm-hmm. Take off the amount we've already accounted for, so the 95%.
So that gives us 4.7%. And so if we split that in 2, then we're going to have 2.35% in each area there.
Okay. Now, keeping in mind that the area, the total area under this curve is accounting for 100% of our data.
Yes.
What should the area of each of these little regions add up to?
100%.
Right. So
yeah.
So can we use that information to help us figure out what the area is in these little tails?
Right, so if we take 100% and we subtract off 99.7%, mm-hmm. then that's 0.3%.
Dividing that by 2, they each get 0.15%.
Mm-hmm. I think it's worth noting, too, that this is a rule, kind of like a theorem. I'm just thinking if I were to see this for the first time as a student, I might be like, how do you know that it's 68% when you go one standard deviation? This is a rule that's given to us to be true.
Right. At this stage, what we can do is work with it.
Right.
And if my wishes came true, it would have been you.
We're going to use the empirical rule to describe the distribution.
Okay.
So basically, here's a picture of our nice empirical rule. And all we have to do is put in the Taylor Swift folklore specific. What we're graphing along the horizontal axis is our length of each song. And what are the units on that?
In minutes.
Correct.
Yeah, we always want to label our horizontal axis.
Okay, now remind me, what is the mean?
The mean was that 3.98.
Cool. 3.98.
Mm-hmm.
And then what was the standard deviation?
Our standard deviation was 0.53. So to label that next bar there, we've got to take 3.98 and add 0.53.
Right. Let's get some, like, you always want to get the bones of your graph by labeling like, along the horizontal. Tell me with the calculations.
So that's 4.51.
So one standard deviation to the right, we have 4.51. So that would be the song with a z-score of 1, just throwing in some review.
Yes.
What would be the song length with a z-score of 2, or 2 standard deviations from the mean?
So that would be 5.04, just adding another 0.53.
Right, each time.
Mm-hmm.
So we did that again, and then we'll do it again.
Yep, so then that's 5.57.
And that's probably enough. We could go further if we need to, but we know we've got almost all of the data by 3 yep. standard deviations. Yeah. Okay. Talk to me about like Z is negative 1 or 1.
So
standard
the when we go to the left, we can subtract 0.53. So 3.98 minus 0.53 is 3.45.
Great.
And then 2.92. And then 2.39, and that's good. So 68% of the songs are between 3.45 minutes and 4.51 minutes.
Great. And then 95% of the songs are between
2.92 and 5.04.
Etc. Love it. All right, let's do some more specific problems.
All right. So what percentage of songs are between 2.92 and 5.04 minutes? So we're going to go ahead and highlight the area between those two values.
Okay. So we want to know what proportion of songs is in there.
And since we've already labeled that so beautifully, we can simply add those percentages together, can't we?
Yeah, or we can know this is the 68.95.
Either way.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Either way you get there, what's the percentage going to be?
95%
there in that purple color.
Yep.
Nice. What about the next one?
So what percentage of songs are between 2.39 and 4.51? So same thing. We're just going to highlight between those two.
Yeah. So this is one of those times when having the each little region labeled as with its percentage is advantageous because right. It's not one of our perfectly symmetrical empirical rule sections. Yep. So we'd have 2.35%, 13.5%, and then the 68%.
Mm-hmm.
And if we add all those up, what do we
get? 83.85%.
And doesn't it look like that's about 83.85%?
Yeah, totally.
Okay, let's try another one.
So what percentage of songs are shorter than 2.92? So shorter would be like less, right? Which means right. We're gonna J to the left.
Correct. Okay, so that means we really just wanna know what percentage of songs are in those two little regions there in like orange.
Right, so we just take 2.35%, we add it to the 0.15%, and we just get 2.5%.
Cool. Totally doable.
Yep.
All right. Let's try a couple more.
What percentage of songs are longer than 3.45 minutes? That just means we're going to shade to the right of 3.45.
Aren't we glad we did all that legwork of drawing the picture and labeling it?
Yep.
Because now, look at my creepy coloring. Because now that we've done all that work at the top, these problems are a piece of cake.
Yep. So I think we can just say now that when we add all those percentages together, we get 84%. Yes.
Okay, let's do a couple more like ways that these could be worded because all of these are pretty much the same. Notice that they all, and we're gonna continue with a few more like this, but they all said what percentage?
Yes.
So our answers were percentages, which are also geometrically interpreted as area.
Right.
And they are probabilities and proportions. Let's keep going.
All right, what percentage of songs are more than two standard deviations away from the mean length of 3.98 minutes? So we go two standard deviations.
So like this would be one, two standard deviations. So two standard deviations away on the right.
Mm-hmm. And if we want to know what percentage of songs are more than that. So we're going to shade to the right.
Okay, but could you be two standard deviations away to the left too?
Yeah.
Yeah, we could go, because a lot of people will forget because they see the more than, so it's very tempting to shade to the right. But isn't this two standard deviations away?
Yeah, we don't want to forget that.
Yeah, and everything I'm shading over here on the left is also more than two standard deviations away from the mean.
That's right. And so if we add all of those percentages together, we're going to get a nice 5%.
Right. 2.5 plus 2.5. Oops. So 5%. Nice. And also that goes with, we know it's the 68.95, so that middle is 95%. So scales are 5%, adds up to 100%. It all fits together perfect.
That's right.
So that was another what percent. So we gave our answer as a percentage, but now things get switched up just a little bit.
Okay. So this says 16% of songs on this album are longer than how many minutes?
So what are we actually trying to find this time if we're given the area, the percentage, what do we want to find?
So ultimately we're trying to find an X value here, right? We want that boundary on the horizontal.
Right. So find X such that the area to its what, right or left?
To the right.
Is 16%. Okay, so where would that be in our picture? This picture is a little harder to draw because you can't just go, oh, that's the boundary and now I shape.
Right.
So we can kind of, what I like to do is I start over on the right.
Mm-hmm.
And I go, okay, I've got 16%. If I start shading from the right and I work my way into a boundary,
mm-hmm.
I only have 2.5% to my right here. Do we agree?
Yep.
Okay, so that's not enough. But yeah. If we add 13.5%.
Okay, so now we're at 16, actually. Exactly.
Right. So all of this is our area of 16%. So the X value that marks that off?
4.51.
Yeah. Okay. So a percentile is an X value, a boundary, such that that percent of the data is below it.
Okay.
So the 84th percentile means I want to know what's the boundary such that 84% of the data is to the left.
Okay. So we start in from the left this time.
Yeah. In fact, we could actually probably just build on our graph above.
Yeah. So if we have 16% on the right in number 8, that mm-hmm. means to the left of it, that's actually 84%, isn't it?
Right, so we kind of don't need a new graph because we can notice if we have 16% to our right, then we also simultaneously are marking off 100% minus 16%,
mm-hmm.
84% to our left.
Right.
And percentile means that's what's below you or left of you. So it's still the same answer, 4.51 minutes. It's kind of two ways to obtain the same X value or
yep.
describe it.
Yeah.
Right. We're also doing a little something there. We're working with the idea of a complement
mm-hmm.
in probability, which we haven't talked about yet, but everything, that's why I love this class, is every little bit is like a little Easter egg for something to come.
That's a good analogy.
Just like in Taylor Swift music videos.
It really all came together there.
All right, so thank you so much for all your help. I am going to go listen to some sweet jams.
Yay.
Yay. Okay.
Right now.
Bye.
Bye.
But we were something, don't you think so? Roaring 20s, tossing pennies in the pool. And if my wishes came true.